Scotland is known for having recorded the strongest ever gust of wind in the United Kingdom.
The summit of Cairngorm, a mountain in the Scottish Highlands, recorded the country's strongest ever gust of 150.3 knots or 173 miles per hour in 1986.
This makes Scotland one of the most ideal areas to harness wind energy. But is simply building more wind turbines the answer to lowering your energy bill?
The Shetland Isles are the northernmost region of the United Kingdom. In the 1970s, huge oil reserves were discovered both east and west of this rugged landscape, giving the economy a much-needed boost and a source of income other than fishing.
As the UK looks to phase out fossil fuels and wean itself off of Russian gas, it's wind energy that is said to boost the region's economy this time around.
Alistair Phillips-Davies is the CEO of SSE, one of Europe's biggest energy companies.
This project's been a long time in the making. It's been 15 plus years, so a huge amount of work has gone into planning it, making sure the turbines are in the right spaces here to maximise wind.
SSE is building 103 turbines and using 257 kilometres of subsea cables to connect the onshore Viking wind farm to the Great Britain grid, which should have the capacity to provide energy for 500,000 homes, including every home in Shetland.
Shetland is going to be an energy hub going forward, so it actually is a template that we intend to use elsewhere in terms of how we expand out the network.
The turbines turn wind into energy through the aerodynamic force from the rotor blades. Each of the wind turbines in a wind farm are linked together by underground cables. These cables then carry the energy to a transformer substation. From there, it's transported to homes, factories, businesses, or schools through the distribution networks of various electricity companies.
This effectively is the harvesting point for the renewable generation. And from here, we turn it into direct current and we fire it down a cable to the northeast coast of Scotland, where it connects to our transmission network.
This will be the most productive wind farm in the UK, and that'll be the first time that the UK and Shetland have been connected electrically.
But these ambitious goals face challenges. There are reports that green energy projects worth billions of pounds have been put on hold because of a lack of capacity in the UK's power grid. The country's grid was originally built to accommodate a small number of fossil fuel power plants. Now, there are 1,100 projects waiting to plug into the electricity system. This could delay new solar and wind sites by 10 to 15 years, undermining renewable energy companies' ability to attract investment and could threaten the UK's target for 100% of its electricity to be free of carbon emission by 2035.
The grid provides the arterial routes that allow generation both onshore and offshore, and a whole energy mix. Not only will it allow us to supply the demand down south, but it also increases the security of supply and the capability of our network that serves our communities.
The United States and several countries in the European Union are planning to invest hundreds of billions of dollars to modernize their electric grids, in part to accommodate more renewable energy projects too. For many years, the UK has been expanding its wind energy capabilities with a raft of turbines now scattered across the country. Between 2009 and 2020, the amount of electricity generated from wind power in the United Kingdom increased by 715%. Meanwhile, electricity generation from renewable sources in the UK have increased as the production of oil and coal decreased. Meanwhile, the overall fossil fuel share of generation dropped from 42% in 2021 to 40.8% in 2022.
We don't want to be importing oil and gas from far-flung places that we no longer want to deal with and where we no longer trust the regimes. Let's get back to building our own infrastructure, relying on what we've got and making sure not only we get it a lot cheaper, but also we've got a lot more security of supply because we're in control of it.
At the start of 2023, the UK government outlined proposals to reform the so-called capacity market to prevent electrical blackouts and to encourage investment in low-carbon technologies. The proposals could be the start of an energy storage boom.
The government has even gone on to fund at least 5 energy storage projects across the UK, part of $40 million allocated for the country's energy security. The UK is experiencing more periods running entirely on energy produced without burning coal, including a stretch in 2020 lasting 67 days. The government has said that it wants to generate enough wind energy to be able to power every home in the UK by 2030. With that in mind, a lot more may have to be done to make wind energy a bigger source of power in the very near future.